Can you tell us just in 30 seconds or less what the movie is about and what is a demo?
Yeah, so Mooman is not a horror figure. It came from this is an underground topic, the film, and it's like a figure who is discovering new things under the cultural surface. And the film is about subculture and the community, which exists since the 80s, I think, or the mid 80s, and they made audiovisual artworks using computers, but not the usual way. So they don't use animation programs, they don't draw in the usual ways, but they make computer programs. So the result is an executable program, which is running on the computer real time, and it generates the visual and the sounds. So it's a new way of making audiovisual artworks using computers.
Would you say that it's something like digital graffiti or something like that?
Yeah, someone said as this words, but yeah, it's something like making art using just mathematics and writing program codes. So I think it needs a different thinking about.
Yeah, but it's also very interesting melange because mathematics, it's science, and visual stuff is art and culture. And I was wondering, do you think that demo is that sort of way of trying to learn how the computer works and sort of get it really familiar and use it in the own artistic way? Because it started in the 80s when computers were very new and people were trying to learn how to use it as a tool to create art.
Yes, absolutely, and it's a naive form of art, I think, because you can't learn in a school this. You can learn programming, or you can learn making music with computer programs, but these guys learned it from themselves, so it's a kind of experimenting with new things. So most of these people get their computers when they was young guys, and they just started to make some fun with the computers, not just playing, but some other things. And this is how this demo scene can be in the present too, because people try to make different things with the computer.
Okay, they look like geeks, but do they have regular day jobs, and what do they do when they do not make demos?
Yeah, of course, and I think the most important part of the filmmaking for us was to show that this is a community, so this is not just guys who are sitting in front of the computer and making computer programs all day long, but they make these demo parties, they are chatting with each other, they have fun, so it's more about a community than just making demos.
Okay, and I wonder if the demo community changes with the technology, because in your movie they are shown with these giant computers with big screens, and right now we have laptops, we have iPads and stuff. Does it really change, or do you use the old stuff, like old school big computers?
It depends on the guys, because you can find some who make demos only on C64 or these really old computers. But nowadays most of the demos are made on PCs, so they're using the modern computers, but it's also exciting that they make artificial limitations, like the size-limited demos. Because now the computer technology is so strong that you can make photorealistic things with computer, and they need this artificial limitations to compete.
Yeah, I imagine it's much more challenging, and there are also some people from Poland in your movie. They are mentioned as people who drink a lot during those events, but can you tell us something about the artistic values of their demos? What would you say is specific and peculiar for Polish demos?
Yes, I heard from Hungarian guys that Polish demos are very intensive. with intensive music and visual. So I heard that the Chaos Theory, which is in the film, it's the most popular Hungarian intro, that people say it's like it could be a Polish demo, because Polish demos seen like that. So I think it Polish guys make really intensive demos.